and welcome to the show. My name is Alex, and this is TechFlow. I'm really excited, right? Really excited because I've wanted to bring you guys this video for so long. I've worked so hard on it, and I haven't stolen this video from anyone. I've done all the background research myself. I've bought all the products. I've tested it all out. This is my budget Wi-Fi networking. Let's do this. So we all know how much Wi-Fi sucks. You've got a Wi-Fi router in your house and it's just not covering every corner of it. It keeps dropping out. It's just not good. Now there's ways around this. You can install numerous multiple access points around your property. You can hardwire them. You can get power over Ethernet. But it's always best to hardwire an access point. We all know this. It's always best to run a cable. But sometimes in your house, you can't run cables because sometimes, you know, you're renting a property. You don't want to be drilling holes through walls. You can't run cables. Now what's the next best thing? Well, in the middle of 2016, all these companies hit us with something brand new for wireless networking, and it's called mesh. Now, Google entered the mesh networking. They have a service called Google Wi-Fi, or a system called Google Wi-Fi. You've got things like the Netgear Orbi, and you've got the mesh networking system from Eero. Now, pretty much in a nutshell, what you do is these things are, well, you buy a pack of them. One of them is a router, you plug it in, it gives off Wi-Fi, and then you have like maybe one or two other little base units you place around your home. You don't have to run any cables to them, you just plug them in the wall, and they just like mesh together and create one big wireless network with one SSID. So there's one network to connect to, you don't have to change networks, and you can roam around your house and have Wi-Fi coverage everywhere. Sounds like heaven, doesn't it? Well, the only problem is these units are upwards of $300. Now, if you're gonna spend that much money on a mesh unit, you may as well just hardwire access points. But this is a system for people that can't hardwire. This is how to mesh network, well, my way of mesh networking, for about a quarter of the price. Right, so I'm gonna walk you through how to do this step by step. It's not an easy process, so listen carefully and let's do this together. If you wanna buy the equipment, all the equipment is linked in the description. Let's go. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is turn off the Wi-Fi on your computer or laptop and plug into the main router in your house via an Ethernet cable. Now, just before we get into how we set this thing up, I'm gonna run a quick speed test so we can see what speeds I'm actually pulling into the office right now. It's about 47 megabytes. The next step, once you've hardwired into your router via an Ethernet cable, is to log into your router's preference pane by typing in something like 192.168.0.1 in the URL bar. Each router is different and you can find your router's IP address probably online by searching its name and model number. Once you've logged into the router, it's probably best to do so if you haven't already to change the router's password for security purposes. Once you've done that, navigate over to the wireless settings. Now you are gonna need a dual band router for this. Most routers nowadays are dual band, but don't worry if you don't have a dual band router, you can pick up one of the extenders which we're gonna be talking about later. It can also act as a dual band access point. So by now, hopefully we're in the configuration page of the Wi-Fi of your main house's router. What we're gonna wanna do is change the 2.4 gigahertz frequency SSID to something that you choose. Maybe you like to have your Wi-Fi name as something funny, maybe it's the name of your house, maybe it's your last name, whatever you want, this is gonna be the Wi-Fi that you connect to. So make sure you name it appropriately. So put that name in there, I'm just gonna call it TechFlow Test. And then obviously add some security to it. I'm just gonna use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for this demonstration. Now the 2.4 gigahertz link, which you've just named and put security on, that is gonna be the network that you're gonna connect to on your phone. But now what you wanna do is scroll down to the 5 gigahertz band and change the SSID to something totally random. And it doesn't matter because you're never ever gonna see this SSID or use it. I'm just gonna call it backhaul. And then again, put a password on it. Just for demonstration purposes, I'm gonna use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Click save and you can now disconnect from your router. Unplug your Ethernet cables and that's pretty much the router configured. The next thing to do is plug in your first Netgear range extender. Now, I know what you're thinking, Alex, all you're doing is extending the range. No, I'm not. We're gonna mod these things and set them up in a certain way which acts like a mesh system. The next step, what you wanna do is plug in the first range extender and then Ethernet into it into your laptop, open up your web browser and type this link in down here. http://mywifiext.net. There you go, you can put it in below. Once you've done that, it's gonna ask you to register and set up the product. Just put your email address and password in and all that malarkey and then click next. Once you've got into your Netgear extender, you're gonna wanna click skip and just get to the main page of it. You don't wanna set this thing up as a wireless extender. What we wanna do is get to the main page of this thing, click on Do More, and then Fastlane. We're then gonna click on Fastlane Technology, and then click on Router to Extender in 5 GHz. You then wanna click on Continue. The Netgear extender is then gonna scan for wireless networks, and I'm not gonna show this because it's obviously gonna pick up all the networks around me. What you wanna do is click on the one that says Backhaul, and then click Next. It's then gonna ask you for the password for the backhaul network. Ours was 1234567 8. Click Next, and then it's gonna try and connect to your network. Once it's done that, it's gonna ask you to enter the 2.4 GHz extended network SSID and password. So for this, you're gonna wanna enter, in our case, TechFlow test, as this is the same network that we've configured on the router and the 2.4 GHz side. This is the network that we want to connect our phones to and seamlessly roam around the house with. And then you have to enter the same password as what you used for TechFlow test on the main router. Once you've done that, click Next. What will happen then is the range extender will reboot itself, and then it's pretty much set up. Now, you can have multiple range extenders around your house, multiple range extenders that are set up in the same way. You just have to go and set up your second one, or your third one, or your fourth, and your fifth in the exact same way we've just set up this one. And then what you want to do is go and position them in places around your home where you see fit. You can use the indication lights on the Netgear range extender to see if you're close enough or too far away from your router. Now, I know this isn't a true mesh system, and I know this isn't going to give you blazing fast speeds, but it's going to work very, very well. And the thing is, you're not repeating the signal, so you're not halving the signal. With a usual wireless repeater, using the same band to transmit and receive the data to your client device and back to the router, therefore it halves the speed. With this, you're not doing that. You connect to your router in 5.8 GHz and you connect it to your phone in 2.4. There's no speed halving involved at all. Now, to get three of these things set up, it's probably gonna cost you around $120, which is like 1/4 of the price of a full-on mesh system. Now, if your goal is to be able to have, you know, fairly fast Wi-Fi that you're gonna be able to do some light gaming on, some email and web browsing, and easily watch and stream YouTube and Netflix videos all around your house, this is gonna do the job absolutely fine, like without any problems at all, and more. Well, don't take my word for it. Let's go and do some speed tests with and without the range extenders, or, you know, our little mesh system installed. But before you go and do that, once you've got all your extenders set up, you want to go ahead and connect back to your main router, put 192.168.0.1 back into your web browser, or whatever your IP address for your router is, and then go ahead, go down to the 5 GHz network and disable broadcast SSID, which pretty much what that's gonna do is gonna stop the backhaul wireless network from being discoverable by your iPhone, which just makes things look a little bit cleaner when you're searching for Wi-Fi networks. You'll only have the one Wi-Fi network, TechFlow test, available to join, and it'll be there covering your whole house. Right, let's go and do some tests. Right, so what good would all this be, right, if I didn't show you guys any examples of actually what it does? So we're in the TechFlow den right now, as you can see. We've got our main router set up just down there. So I'm in the vicinity of the main router. I'm gonna do a speed test right now. We're connected to our new Wi-Fi network. Gonna begin the test. As you've seen by wired connection that I showed off at the start of the video, we were getting about 47 megabytes, which is the cap of our leased line here. So let's just do a quick test here and see what we're pulling right next to the router for Wi-Fi. So as you can see, 25, 24, 23 meg, right? 24 meg, right? Which is okay for a 24 gigahertz connection. Sorry, 2.4 gigahertz connection. So, location number two. This is gonna be a test without any of our extenders plugged in. Right, so as you can see, I've got one bar of Wi-Fi. Gonna see if I can do a speed test here. Oh no, my phone has just clicked onto 4G. I've lost the Wi-Fi, I've just lost it. Brilliant. Right, location number three. Our office is on the top floor of this building. We're now on the bottom floor of this building in the opposite corner. And yet, I don't have any Wi-Fi signal. There's no point in even doing the test. Right, let's go and turn on our little extenders. Right, so let's turn on extender number one, turn on extender number two, Now, there really isn't any point in doing another speed test in the office because having the extenders on isn't going to impact the signal connected directly to the main router at all. If I do a speed test again, I'm probably going to see exactly the same results as we did before. We may as well wait for it to do it, seeing as I've already clicked it. So we're going to wait for a ping to come through. There we go. As you can see, brilliant speeds on the internet, even faster than before. Right, so we're back in the first location right now where we had no signal to the main router at all. With our extenders plugged in, I've got one bar of signal. The walls in this building are absolutely massive. The covering this building would be near impossible, but I'm trying to demonstrate here that we actually do have signal this time and it's not just giving us absolutely nothing. And as you can see, the speeds are easily enough gonna let you web browse and watch YouTube videos. That's pulling over 10 megabytes there. And these walls are all solid brick. This is an old building. Okay, back in location three, connected now to, well, hopefully one of the hotspots. I've got two bars to it. We are so far away from the main router. 11 ping and 12, 13, 14, 15, 15 meg. Easily gonna be able to web browse on that, watch YouTube videos and do a bit of light gaming with that 11 ping. This building is massive. And I am now, well, I've tested both ends of the building. We've still got connection. The upload seems to be even faster, coming in at 30 meg, which is absolutely incredible. Let's just jump on YouTube real quick, see if we can load a simple YouTube video in like 1080p or something. What's in my subscriptions? Unbox therapy. Let's see.
I finally got the AirPods. I almost said earpods.
Believe it or not.
Working absolutely fine. So this works. This what I've designed here, this little mechanism thing, it works. It's a mesh Wi-Fi system. You have to do it in the way that I've done it so it works the best way. You're not necessarily using these as repeaters, which is what they're meant to be used for, using them as a bit of a mesh. This, it works. And it's like literally a quarter of the price of a full-blown mesh unit. Yes, you've got to set it up yourself, but it's fun and it's cheap and it gets the job done. Hope you've enjoyed. My name's been Alex, it's been TechFlow. We'll catch you in the next one.